Hello, I'm Dr. Naima Kovacin, and I'm an assistant professor in the Mayo Clinic College of Medicine. And today I will talk about an article that I wrote together with my co-authors and that will appear in the Mayo 2018 issue of the Mayo Clinic Proceedings. The paper is entitled Experimental Weight Gain Increases Ambulatory Blood Pressure in Healthy Subjects, Implication of Visceral Fat Accumulation. This study was supported by the NIH and by the American Heart Association. We all know that obesity is a growing epidemic, and it has been linked with increased risk of cardiovascular diseases, including hypertension. However, only few studies have investigated the effects of experimental weight gain on blood pressure. Importantly, we need to understand whether it is the overall fat gain or the accumulation of fat in specific body regions that is more likely to cause cardiovascular diseases. Therefore, we conducted this study to examine whether experimental weight gain raise blood pressure and to identify any relationship between changes in blood pressure and changes in regional fat distribution by using imaging techniques. We recruited 26 healthy normal weight subjects and we randomized them to an 8-week period of either moderate weight gain, about 5% increases in body weight, which was achieved through overfeeding, or to weight maintenance. And then we found that those randomized to weight gain exhibited an increase in 24-hour ambulatory blood pressure. Specifically, we found that systolic blood pressure increased on average by 4 mm of mercury after an approximate 5% increase in body weight. While this magnitude of blood pressure elevation may seem negligible, it is actually prognostically significant because even a 2 mm of mercury increase in blood pressure is associated with 10% higher risk of stroke on a population level. In addition, we showed that the elevation in blood pressure was selectively and independently associated with accumulation of fat in the visceral depot, meaning the fat located inside the abdomen, as we did not find any relationship between changes in blood pressure and increased total fat or subcutaneous fat or changes in total weight. Visceral fat may promote blood pressure increases because of its endocrine and paracrine properties. Visceral fat is indeed metabolically more active than subcutaneous fat and releases several agents that can promote inflammation, vascular dysfunction, and sodium retention, which in turn will lead to blood pressure increases. The take-home message of this article is that even modest weight gain can cause blood pressure elevation, and that the blood pressure increases are selectively associated with increases in visceral adipose tissue, suggesting that healthy subjects who are predisposed to visceral fat gain are also predisposed to increases in blood pressure, independently of established risk factors. Therefore, the accumulation of abdominal visceral fat may be the key contributor to the high risk of hypertension, which is associated with weight gain and obesity, as reported by several observational studies. From a clinical standpoint, our findings highlight how the conventional assessment of body weight by scale measures or measurements of waist circumference may be insufficient to stratify patients for risk of hypertension and other cardiovascular diseases. Evaluation of regional distribution of fat should be considered in the clinical practice. It is also possible that individuals with pre-existing medical condition may be even more vulnerable to the pressure response associated with increases in visceral fat. Hence, they may need to be more closely monitored. Our findings also emphasize the adverse impact of modest weight gain. Although the public awareness of the negative effects of obesity is increasing, the risks associated with modest weight gain seem to be overlooked. People should be aware that gaining even a few extra pounds, as it may occur during vacation or the holiday season, may contribute to an increase in blood pressure if fat is predominantly accumulated in the visceral area. They may also be relevant for college students, as the fat gain during those years, the infamous freshman 15, may be setting them up for later onset of hypertension. Further studies need to be undertaken in order to identify the molecular and physiological mechanisms mediating the elevation in blood pressure after weight gain. Specifically, we need to understand whether visceral fat gain is indeed a causative in the blood pressure increases, or whether there is a third factor driving increases in both visceral fat and blood pressure. We hope you enjoy our article.
We hope you found this presentation from the content of Mayo Clinic Proceedings valuable. Our journal's mission is to promote the best interests of patients by advancing the knowledge and professionalism of the physician community. If you are interested in more information about us, our homepage is www.mayoclinicproceedings.org. There you will find access information for our social media content, such as additional videos on our YouTube channel or journal updates on Facebook. You can also follow us on Twitter. More information about healthcare at Mayo Clinic is available at www.mayoclinic.org. This video content is copyrighted by Mayo Foundation for Medical Education and Research.